if you would have the opportune date that you could ask for and say, okay, God, I'm going out to paint tomorrow and here's what I want. I would like about 65 degrees. I want no wind. I would like high overcast and no bugs. You would think you'd died and gone to heaven, but you might get one or two out of that list. Okay, well, this would be perfect. I am an oil painter and a pastelist. I basically started at 10 years of age. A neighbor lady asked my twin and I to come over and sit. She wanted to paint our portraits, and I was completely intrigued with watching her put paint on a canvas. I have painted almost continuously, so I basically started at 10 years of age. I primarily paint still life, landscapes, do a lot of pet portraiture. I do not paint people. In the last years, plein air became something that was very, very important to me, and so I was outdoors painting a lot. So I am seeing, with all this yellow-green, I'm seeing a purple. Plein air painting means to be painting in the air, outside, and it is probably the fastest growing genre right now in the United States. It offers a tremendous amount of challenges. First of all, you have roughly a half hour to catch a light pattern in whatever it is you're painting. And then if you're able to edit everything out and only get in your lights, your middle tones, and your shadows, you can then work for approximately another hour on that piece and still have a sense of the time that you did this. And it truly is a skill builder. Other than the fact you need to watch for anthills and snakes and critters and bugs and rain and thunder and snow and those things, plein air is really a lot of fun. To keep everything from getting wet. So we'll just kind of wait it out. My husband would be the very first one to tell you, if I get crabby, he just tells me to go to the studio. I can relax. I can have been out in the garden and be exhausted and come here into the studio and pick up a pastel or my paintbrush and my paint. And for 2 hours, I'm totally lost. It's like another world. I'm relaxed, even when I'm struggling with a painting. As a painter, what I feel is, while you are trying to decide what color of green you need to put on that tree and where, because you're totally absorbed in what you're doing. You cannot be worrying about whether the car is going to need to be repaired or whether you've got money for rent or some of the other daily problems that you have. And so for me, it is just like a fantastic relaxation. I paint pretty much what feels interesting and fun to me. And I think if I'm enjoying it, I'm hoping that somebody else will enjoy it. And so far, it's worked out pretty well. I probably could sell a whole lot more paintings if I did not follow my heart and what I really enjoy and want to paint. So I really don't paint for fashion at all. I think my biggest nightmare is people that would come into our studio and they would have all their swatches and they say, we need a painting to match the sofa. So I have a t-shirt that says, good art does not have to match the sofa.
Production funding is provided by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund and the citizens of Minnesota, and by the members of Prairie Public.